was hoping I'd have some pop tarts. We got some pop corn. This is video number 2. I did edit my last video. All that trying to solve a puzzle that was glitched out wouldn't work. Pointless. I learned a new console command that you're basically gonna have to know. If you, at least if you play the disc version of this game like I do, which is a debug mode, then you know, 16A puzzle update or update puzzle. Puzzle. Just the age type of art kind. I really enjoyed this character. Playing on the hardest difficulty is really hard. Really, really hard at certain points. Like earlier in this city, Neverwinter. Outside of it, before that, I had to fight an army of orcs, like a literal army of orcs. It's crazy. Yeah, that was pretty hard. I hit 9. You had to fight the watch, city watch. Yeah, some dude's mansion. That's all I'm saying. I died like 10 times, I think. I tried really hard too. I had to use like tactics. I had to like go to one door, secretly take those out. I even tried like having me and my panther sneak to the front, you know, ahead, kill those, and then call my party in to fight the others. And I just did all the quick stuff. Didn't work out though, because at the second floor, I think you have to fight, because on the first floor, you can use that cloak that you steal from the outside guards, and the guards in there won't fight you. Except two at the door when you leave. Pretty like that. Where's this bishop guy? Where'd he go? Right, I'm ready to go. What do I need to do? There's some taco bell left over there. Oh, heat that up. One of those cantina bowls.
You about ready to leave? Every moment we wait, your farm girl gets farther away.
I don't need potions. I got healing kits, so I should get them.
Hold on. Something isn't right. Now you're learning. Good. Keep listening to me and you might stay alive. But it's not just the villagers. Where are the livestock? They didn't take them all to market, trust me. We're on the trail of our friends, though. They're moving fast, but it looks like we've closed in a bit.
I see. Suck.
Their trail's hard to miss. They may know where they're going, but they aren't bothering to hide their tracks. It's almost as if they want us to keep up. I don't like it. Keep your eyes open and your weapon handy. I smell an ambush.
Okay. Had a little popcorn. Okay, use the spell against the orcs. Turn undead for a while. Together.
My steel will strike true. Nice little ambush they planned here. Decent effort, sloppy execution. It might have even worked if I hadn't been here. Ah, and I was wondering where their reinforcements were. Come on, we're not done here yet.
What's her weapon?
Everybody, follow me!
Perhaps so.
I've been fighting this whole time without weapon.
Station.
I use that sometimes. Or sometimes. Can I heal him? Am I out of healing kits? Yep. I screwed up. When I run out of healing kits, I lose. Could just use spontaneous conversion.
That pulse is full.
Give me a pulse.
Go back.
That pulse is full. They left a large force in this village, which means it'll be easier on us when we catch up to the others, as long as we catch them before they go to ground. Well now, aren't you a bright ray of hope? But you're right, and what's more, our friends won't be leaving an obvious trail this time, since they don't have the men to bait any more ambushes. A little difficult, but we handled it. More than could be said for the villagers here giving up their homes to the enemy. Surprised the Giths left any of them alive. It'd be more mercy than I'd show them. Tell me you're not as blind as you seem. You're from West Harbor, right? Duncan told me what happened there. What do you think would have happened to your little swamp village if all of you had decided to surrender and wait the Gith out? You know what would have happened as well as I do. At least I admit it. All right then, let's head out. We have a lot of ground to cover, and I'll—
Forgive me. You— Are you hunting a woman, Chandra Jarrow? Yeah. Those creatures. We heard her screaming as they were carrying her off. I tried to call out to her, but I didn't realize they had her at first. But she makes a merchant run through Ember and Port Last during harvest season. We hadn't seen her yet this year, though. And sorry, where are my manners? I am Elaine. Please, I saw the beast taking her to the mountains to the north and east. They barely have an hour on you, but they were moving fast. And thank you for saving us from those creatures. I can't thank you.
Listen to our leader. Next time, fight, girl. Or next time, you'll die. Now, can we go without more mewling dogs getting in our way? Every moment we wait, the trail gets colder.
Well. see what saves I have here. Let's save them at table one, like always. Okay. Whoops. My bad. I should have got some healing kits and some potions. Stock up when you can. I guess it's a little bit of fun. I'm just kidding. In my case, anyway. Let's go to Hot Cliff first. Get some healing kits. That's why I keep mine and my party alive. I just heal them. Use spontaneous conversion. Alrighty.
Yeah. Stay close. It's step where I step.
let's get lots of these. I'm just gonna buy them all. There's something to supply these things. I'll just use the plus ones. Since there's an infinite supply of them. Just hold many of them here. I can't do the shift click thing for some reason. So I'm gonna get carpal tunnel with this, right? Potions of bliss, potions of bliss. Endurance. Some cheap stuff. Works out good. Good old fashioned bliss. My favorite merchant in the game because he never runs out of stuff. Just a little trick I picked up. You get a infinite supply of cure disease potions. The priest at Fort Locke. I'm sure there's other versions like that too. And it's not a cheat or anything, it's just. No, it is. The very weak potions, but they work. And they clutch. And you just have to have. Just have to have them. Mostly for your comrades, really. I'll spend the rest on healer's kits. I'll travel with my other companions later and get their stuff and sell it. Which would work. Good for now. Okay, let's go ahead and save. Alright. safe somewhere. Yeah, I do. I'll just leave that where it is. Githyanki base. Okay. There we go. Got some cheap magics. Panther doesn't do much damage, but he can. Oh, that thing can dodge anything. He doesn't get hit at all. It's crazy. I'm gonna command him to always be stealthy. When you're stealthy, Panther, I will be too. That is daytime. Some type of problem with the game that does that. Just shifts into the room like that.
Now, strike swiftly.
The alarm. We're going to hear that the whole time. How sweet, you want to tangle too?
Come on.
gathering intel, guys.
What's going on? Yeah? Which one of the marks you wanted to know about? Not the barrelhead dwarf, is it? Well, he needs to watch his tongue, or it's gonna run right out of his mouth and get stepped on. I mean, you did me a good turn. All I want to do is help out, and he's yelling at me like some old mule. I know he's short, and it's rough being in the big people's world. But he needs to stop being all defensive, especially for someone so small. Of my life. You'd be surprised how much you hear that when you're about to be burned at the stake or run out of the local hamlet. He's too quick to start fights. That's his problem. He keeps it up, he's not going to have anyone watching his back. Or more likely, looking over it.
Up my plan. Damn you, Grabnar. easy up until now. Just go ahead then.
Farm girl again? No matter how tough this Jarrow Haven is to enter, there's a way to pick any lock rather than using the key. Let the Gith have her. They'll probably let her go as soon as she opens her big mouth and starts complaining.
Zieri has foretold your coming, Kalakcha. She has sent me to end you. I enjoy gnawing my prey, Kalakcha. I find it sweetens the taste of their death. Zieri allows me this luxury. My name is unimportant. You need only know that Zieri has granted me the honor of killing the Kalakcha and taking your head as a trophy back to the astral plane. Zieri is a sword stalker of the highest order. She is favored by the Lich Queen and has slain countless enemies. We sword stalkers are an elite order, tasked by the Lich Queen to recover our silver swords that have been lost and hunt the fools that steal them. Silver swords are the Lich Queen's sacred gift to her knights. Many outsiders covet their power. Their theft is the highest crime an outsider can commit. Vlakith, the Lich Queen, has been our leader for millennia. Her greatness is second only to Gith herself. I don't wish to speak of her further. You dare question my devotion to the Lich Queen? Slay the Kalakcha! For Zieri!
Zieri!
There is a problem.
Handle it! I am not finished here.
My battlefield was pretty much chaos. Pretty much.
Everyone
That would be nice. That would be nice for somebody else. For me. I need dexterity. And this was the tricky part. It slows me too, so at this difficulty. Every AoEs affect everybody. So you gotta be careful. Once you get them all out of range, you can rest again, I guess. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Succubus. It's hard to move around the battlefield right now. Where's Grabnar? There he is. To heal him. I'll cause fear on her. Again. I'm going to end up being used to spell of some kind. There we go. Got it. Poison that bitch. That's the first succubus I fought. See how powerful that spell is that I use, that slow movement spell? It's crazy. Okay. Alright, now
both up.
Find the Githyanki leader and retrieve the shards from her Zexus. Leave no one alive.
Remember him.
As for these newcomers, deal with them.
Pretty hard. Okay, let's see. Some of the boar. Physical attacks work against them, I guess. I'm not sure. They have an illusion spell. Son of a bitch, man. I used dispel magic. Trust true saying, I don't know. Isn't that ironic? Ravnar is so powerful, he used their own tactics against them. That's funny. I got a level up already. I'm not already, it's been a long time. See if I can hold her. I'm pretty powerful. Nah, not that powerful though. A succubus is a weak version of a demon. Gotcha, bitch. Fire probably won't do much against that. Huh? No. Arrow the vampire. Nope. Gotta use a normal arrow. Normal arrow. Oh, I get the arrow plus one. That worked. Come on, everybody. Now, strike swiftly. Truck. Turn over there.
Show me what you've got.
That taunt might work.
Show me what you've got.
Taunt's for work. Could use lesser restoration. Give her a sound burst. Give her a bane. Give her these. that's not working. Let's see. Just, put poison there. Level 2. Lesser restoration. Level 1. Magic weapon. Shield of faith. I need all of that. Spell metal. all of the spell magic. Yeah, that's that'll work. I gotta replace something with it. There. I think that's better. Let's check and see. I don't need all of that. Things have changed. Go ahead and save now. I'm not big on the offensive spell, really. Cleric doesn't really have one. I was gonna see if there was some way I could heal hardest difficulty. It really is the hardest difficulty. It is. Alright. Let's see. Still can't be a war priest. Let's see why. Take my weapon off. Attack bonus is plus 4. So after this will be plus 5, I guess. One more cleric level. Let's see. I'm gonna need the diplomacy. I think.
Yes.
level 6 spells. Spirit of the bear, spirit of the bear. Let's see. This is situational, but I'm gonna go to sanctuary. This room here. Magic weapon. Entangle and do. I can change it up later if I want to. What's that? I don't need one of these bull strength there. Two. Use bull strength and something else, I don't know. Alright. What do I want to do? Use restoration. Already got the spell. Okay, there we go. Alright. That's a good list of stuff. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Some are situational, which you don't have to have at this point, it seems. I'm gonna have to relearn combat now.
Listen, when I strike it, it's like the tolling of a bell.
I can still smell the stench of its creator on its surface, running deep into the ore. Why would the Gith keep such a thing, as broken as it is? We should tear it apart, see if its limbs twitch when cleaved from the body.
Why, it seems one victim has drawn others.
Oops. Stay on the side. I got too soon. Fine. I switched the bow then. Light? I don't know.
About time we got to killing.
is my favorite command. Wait, no, that's too many. My favorite command is attack nearest. Buff my bear. Ooh, cat sprays. Big waste of a cat.
Oh my! This is a marvelously constructed, construct! To think of the enchantments that must have been inscribed on its core. Fascinating!
Huh. Anything being torn apart by demons is an ally in my book.
Why, he's the very same kind of blade golem construct that appeared in Neverwinter. But it looks damaged. Inert. Looks like the Githyanki here captured this golem and somehow severed it from whoever was controlling it and damaged it in the process. Perhaps your attacks helped damage it. Although its captors seem to have done their fair share of torture, it certainly isn't an ally of the Githyanki. Which means there's at least one more player drawing the cart around this whole circle of ambushes and counter-ambushes. How perplexing. You know, given some time, I think I can get it working again. Maybe once we get back to the sunken flagon, I can tinker with it, get it working again.
Kill the Gith first. Wanna do that? Wanna do that?
Thank you.
Shit. Attacking waves. Guerrilla tactics with a nature cleric. Valorius Virionon. So many spells, now I can't even keep up with them all. The more the merrier. Silver shard. Why can't it tangle the imp? It's flying. One tangle spell is really powerful. It always gets me. In my own. Push my head, what the hell? No, I just dispelled myself. Let's see here. I used bow and sword, so I'll just get something else with that there. See, level 2. Resist energy. That's good. That's a good one. Zero. This is one hell of a battle up ahead.
Thank you.
Reading a lot of stuff. I didn't get my 10,000 gold. Thank you, Grabnar. These little farm gnomes are more bigger than the ones at the beginning of the game. My bluff is too low. battle time. AC's being loud, everything's being loud right now. Easy. See if we're gonna poison a demon. No. Dire boar. Booga. Booga.
put them all over the books. Into my library.
I am trying to be. Close to school.
I'm gonna be a war priest if I can be. I remember this part of the game. I didn't know. I didn't think it was a Githyanki base. I thought it was actually Almondra's place. Whatever.
Though these demons were unanticipated, your arrival was not. I've seen it burning brightly in my visions for some time.
How long did you think you could escape us? You have stolen our shards, defiled them with your touch, and now you will die, Kalakcha! Know that you're in no position to demand anything from me. You will answer for your crimes, along with this frail thing that carries the last of the Jiro blood. You already know your crimes. There is no need to recount them now to stall judgment. They did so in response to your crime. As you carry the shards, so must you carry the guilt as well.
Oh, it looks so shimmering. I think it's not fully in this dimension. Just like that barrier we passed on the way here.
It is a door shaped by my people. One that leads to the realms of the Githyanki and maintained by my will alone. Why, the same thing you want from her. She is the last known descendant of one who stole a silver sword from us. You already know the answer. The time for your deceptions is over. Yes, The lives of humans are all too brief. But their sins are passed to their kin. And so has Amangero's crime passed to his descendant. His sword! The blade he stole from us was broken. Instead of prying the blade from his hands, we must hunt down the mess of his crime. Within her thoughts, somewhere is the knowledge I seek. I will leave no memory unturned, no shred of self untouched. And what I have, what I need, I shall execute her. Now you will face your punishment, Kalaksha. It is why your path brought you here, and why the shards you carry will soon be added to mine. If you were in the astral plane, the Lich Queen would see that you were slowly tortured, killed, and then raised again for countless cycles. Your crime merits many deaths. Among the Githyanki, none but the Lich Queen have more authority than I. Enough of this. Know that I will hear your pleas, and allow you this one last chance to atone for your crime. My offer of mercy is this. I will grant a swift, painless death for you and your companions, if you freely hand over the shards you have taken. You lie! Any Githyanki could sense the presence of the shards. Did you really think you could keep such relics of my people? They do not belong to you. Odd. I have all the ones you carry, yet it seems you still possess one.
Spoiler alert.
You have a piece of the sword inside of you.
Sword been so quiet, I'm really into this.
And I shall move it from you by force.
Everybody. Attack the pillars. Attack the pillars.
Sure, I can do that.
Make sure they're equipped.
Of
well.
Course, I can do that.
Attack the dagger. Oh, equip the dagger, bitch. Thank you. to heal myself. Heal myself. I just messed up. Peter, thank you, Blast Globes.
You think this is over? You are wrong, Kalakcha. And I hope the pain you have brought here is revisited upon you a thousandfold. The Lich Queen will know of my fall, yes. But it will be too late. What comes for you will be revenge enough. We were never the ones you had to fear. In defying us, you have harmed your own people, and everything on your plane. The Githyanki will strike at you no longer. This was the last of our strongholds devoted to the recovery of the shards. There will be no more attacks from my people, because it will serve no purpose. You have sealed your fate.
This is the most interesting part of the game, this little
The shards you carry were needed. The shard and you all are needed. Eva wakes Kalakcha. And in killing me, you now stand alone against what comes. An ancient enemy comes for you. One that has existed for millennia. You have already felt the effects of his presence. And he will grow stronger with time. This enemy, this king of shadows, if he succeeds in his plans, your civilization will become dust. And all life will be consumed by darkness. I will see you in death, Kalakcha. I do not think I will have to wait long.
I have to wait this long. First the loot, then the bitches. All the loot, I guess. We're all way wrong on that.
I have to look this thing.
Let's see.
Hey, everyone, follow me.
I need some light armor. Save button, F12, I think it is, F12.
I'm getting so tired of this. You have to let me save you sometime, or else I'll never be able to pay you back.
Oh, there'll be plenty of time for you to pay all of us on the way back to Neverwinter.
You all put me in danger. I'm not paying you a single coin.
Oh, then you'll be paying me another way. My bedroll's a little cold that night. I'm thinking you can fix that.
I could always set you on fire, Bishop. That'd solve two problems.
You wound me, girl. Or is that jealousy I hear? Don't worry, I'll get to you soon enough. Can we go now?
Back to the flagon.
Hey, welcome back! Glad to see you've all returned, and in one piece, no less. All right, out with it. What happened? Tell me the tales, the songs, the whole bit.
I could sing a few of the songs our journey inspired, if you are willing.
Quiet, you. You were about to say. Inside the wound on your chest. That means you've been carrying around the shard almost your entire life. We had no idea.
Ah, notice the stumble in his words. Your uncle has been keeping secrets, I think.
Silence, Bishop. I don't know if I'm the best one to be telling you this. But if you've got one of those shards in you, I think you've earned the right to hear everything. Dagon probably already told you, but when you were an infant, West Harbor was the site of a battle, a terrible battle. The King of Shadows himself led an army of demons against the Neverwinter army, which had gathered at the village. West Harbor was struck suddenly, without warning. There was panic, confusion, villagers fleeing every which way to escape the battle. But Dagon's wife, Shayla, and your mother, Esmeril, did not. They stayed behind to save you. As demons and mage fire rained upon the village, they fought to reach your crib. By the time Dagon even realized they were missing, it was too late. He could only watch from a distance as the village was consumed in the battle. It wasn't my decision to keep what happened to your mother from you. And my brother would be furious, I told you. I guess he thought it would be too much for you. In any case, when the few that remained returned to the village, no one was alive. Except you. Your mother was there. So much blood and... You were clutched in her bosom, a deep wound in your chest. She tried to shield you, but the shard must have cut through her and into you. No one knew how you survived, but you did, and your wound sealed itself within days, leaving the scar that you still bear. But if that wound was due to the shard that pierced you, then that raises many questions, and I'm afraid I'm just all out of answers. Believe me, I wanted to. But my brother...
Why the long faces, you two? Somebody die? If so, sounds like a cause for celebration to me.
Grobnor, you worthless half-man. Strike up a tune before I strike you.
Of course, Sir Bishop. It so happens I have just the tune.
By the way, I've decided it would be in both our interests if I stay on with you.
What? Does a man need a reason? Come now. Duncan's kind request was enough to start this, I think. Why not finish it?
We don't need any more of your help.
No, no. There's no need, Bishop. I'm sorry for before. But you've done more than...
Oh, come now, Duncan. I still owe you. And what better way to make it up to you than watching your kin here? After all, a debt is a debt, all the way until the end. Isn't that right?
I hate to ask, but what happens now? I can't go back to my farm, ashes and all.
Travel with us? Her?
I'd have to agree with Mishka. She's been through enough. Do you think that's wise?
Fine, but she's not getting my share of the treasure.
If that is your decision, so be it. But it is her decision as well, since it endangers her.
I really appreciate the sudden interest from the both of you. But I can take care of myself. Besides, whenever I'm alone, that's when the problems seem to crop up.
If she's going to be with us, she'll need to do some catching up. We can't just keep on rescuing her all the time.
Rescuing me? I can rescue myself. Sometimes, when there's not too many lizard men or Githyanki. Well, I know enough to use a sword, and I can handle myself in a fight. I mean, I'm no spellcaster, but if you need an extra blade... I admit, you've rescued me twice now. And if you're going to help teach me to survive these attacks, I accept. But there's some things you're going to have to accept, too. I don't like being left behind, because whenever you're out of my sight, suddenly all this trouble starts happening, and I'm really tired of it. So, look. I won't try to get in your way or anything, but I don't want us to part ways again. I've lost too much already. You're not leaving me behind, all right? Well, good. Then by your side is where I'm staying.
So the farm girl's going to join our band. Good. We need someone to make up for the paladin, or at least to catch arrows if Grobnar's already dead. For now, I say we crack some of those kegs and drown the flagon in wine.
Ooh, long playthrough. At least everything's working properly. Act 2, there we go. A new act. There's only 3 or 4. One was the longest.
Lord Nasher, forgive us. She said it could not wait.
It is a matter of some urgency, and there is little time. My lord, I come to you with...
You will bow to Lord Nasher.
Of course. I meant no disrespect, my lord.
What brings you here, Torio? If there is some new dispute with Luskan, speak with the Trade Guild first, then...
Oh no, my lord. This matter concerns Neverwinter. There is a murderer loose in your city.
Murderer? And whom has this murderer killed?
An entire village lies dead, my lord.
Naval, have our scouts reported anything about...
The village was slaughtered, and now the murderer hides here within your walls. You must initiate a search at once.
Only one of us wears a crown. Yet you dare to give me orders within my halls? I will do nothing until I confirm this village's destruction. Then, if I see fit, I will act. Do not test me on this.
Whatever pleases you, my lord. But I would act quickly, lest the murderer slip through your fingers. If that were to happen, I have no doubt there would be serious repercussions. I do not need to remind you of the extradition treaty.
By every god and his mother, what a fool I was to ever sign anything bearing Luskan's seal.
I can have Torio detained, Lord Nasher.
No, she would not be so bold if there were not something to her claims. Dispatch scouts, Naval, and order the watch to search the city. I think it would be in our interest to find the killer before Luskan does.
If I may, my lord, I have someone well suited to aid in our search. An agent of ours, Sand. I think that he can help us find our true murderer, no matter how deep Luskan tries to hide him.
Sand? I recall that one. I thought he was our eyes, but not by choice.
In this matter, my lord, we may trust him implicitly. He takes a certain pleasure in bringing Luskan truths to light.
Very well. See to it, Naval, and make haste.
Sit. Make it happen, Neverwinter.
There you are. I am here because Luskin has accused you of murder. An entire village, no less. Have you heard of Ember? I've scraped things from my boot that I respect more than Luskin. But unless we find some means of clearing you of these charges, we will have to surrender you to them. We've signed a treaty with Luskin. They have the right to dispense low justice for any crimes committed on their soil. And despite my feelings in the matter, I'm not turning you over to a Luskin court for justice. Since you have chosen the outlaw's path here in Neverwinter, there is little I can do to help you. Being a knight, even a squire would be enough to keep you from Luskin hands. I do not believe you are guilty of this crime. And while nothing would please me more than to bring you to trial, I won't have it done in a Luskin court. There is more I can try to do on your behalf, but not much. You and your men have placed yourself outside Neverwinter's law, and here is the price. I may send a friend of mine to assist you. He has proven invaluable in such cases in the past. Know this. If you cannot prove your innocence in this matter, our only choice will be to deliver you to Luskin, or Neverwinter herself may pay the price. Do not attempt to leave the city. The gates will be barred to you until Nasher says otherwise.
There you are. Axel sent me to tell you he has someone who wants to meet you. He will be pleased to see you.
No way in the hells will I let those Luskins get their hands on you.
But there's still something you can do, right? Even Naval said as much. All you have to do is pledge yourself to one of the knights and Luskin can't touch you.
And we're innocent, besides. I mean, the slaughter of an entire village? That's going too far, even by Luskin standards.
Is it? If you have something Luskin wants, they'd kill an entire city for it. They don't care. They attacked Neverwinter once, and even now they're sending fleets to attack Ruathim. Give them an excuse and you'll soon find Luskin blades at your gate.
Duncan, looks like we have a guest.
Oh, as if the day couldn't get any worse. What do you want, Sand?
I am here to help you. And your kin, actually.
Oh, really? And what's the price? If it's more than a half copper, you can see yourself out.
No, I seem to have been given an ultimatum, in fact. I have heard of your troubles with Luskin.
Word travels fast.
Know that if you are sent to Luskin, you will be killed. I realize you may find my sincerity difficult to believe, but allow me to act on your behalf. There are laws, and there is right and wrong. While I believe you are quick to take liberties with the law, I do not believe you are guilty of this. And if they should get a hold of you, you will be killed. I believe people should answer for their crimes, but it must be just. Well, at best, they will put you on trial, or what seems to be one, then execute you. At worst, they will dispense with the courtroom mockery and execute you as soon as you step within the gate. And when I say execute, do not think it will be one clean chop of a headman's axe. Luskins have all sorts of inventive ways for executing prisoners that is best not to describe on a full stomach.
I think we should give him the chance. This is not a battle that can be won by swords. And I, for one, am ill-equipped for such a fight.
Sure. After all, a hedge wizard can't make things any worse. Maybe all that digging through books might prove useful.
If we need to burn down Luskin, then perhaps we shall seek you, Quara, but your ignorance will cause more damage here than you know. Luskin is not ruled by men. It is ruled by magic, by the masters of the towers. And if they have decided that you are to be delivered to them, then...
So, let them try.
Whatever spark of magic you think you have, you idiot girl, they will bleed from you by demon, spell, and curse until even your father won't be able to save you. And I suspect that what they seek may have consequence beyond you, beyond me, for much of the realms. If you have connections, as I suspect you now do, I suggest you use them now. Even the honor of becoming a squire of the least respected of Nash's knights would keep you from Luskin's hands. Perhaps your new friend, Axel DeVree, can act where Naval's hands are tied. Let me join with you. I have considerable experience with these matters, and foiling Luskin plots is something I relish.
Well, this is a bit anticlimactic, but go ahead and end this. Thank you for joining me today. Sound like, oh, anyway, goodbye. Neverwinter 2, Neverwinter Nights 2 forever. Woo! Getting exciting. End of Act 1. Yeah. Bye.